In this session, let's know something about audio-lingual method. Introduction. Audio-lingual method, also known as Army method, because after the outbreak of World War II, the army soldiers decided to be proficient in the language of their enemies. So a new learning method of foreign languages was discovered, which is known as audio-lingual method. This method is based on a linguistic theory and behavioral psychology. The audio-lingual method was widely used in the 1950s and 1960s, and the emphasis was not on the understanding of the words, rather an acquisition of structures and patterns in common everyday dialogues. Aims of this method. Oral skills. Oral skills are used systematically to emphasize communication. The foreign language is taught for communication with the view to achieve development of communication skills. Practice. Practice is how the learning of the language takes place. Every language skill is the total of the sets of habits that the learner is expected to acquire. Practice is central to all the contemporary foreign language teaching methods. With the audio-lingual method, it is emphasized even more. Oral learning. Oral learning is emphasized. Stress is put on oral skills at the early year of the foreign language course and is continued during the later years. Oral skills remain central even when later reading and writing are introduced. Learners are asked to speak only what they have had a chance to listen to sufficiently. They read only the material used as part of their practice. They have to write only that which they have read. Strict order of material in terms of the four skills is followed. It is a mechanical method. Since it demands pattern practice, drilling and memorization over functional learning and organic usage. The learner is in a passive role. The learner has little control over their learning. Oral drills. Drills and pattern practice are typical. Reception. The student repeats an utterance as soon as he hears it. Inflection. One word in a sentence appears in another form when repeated. Replacement. One word is repeated by another. Restatement. The student rephrases an utterance. For example, the following example illustrates how more than one sort of drill can be incorporated into one practice session. Teacher, there is a cup on the table. Repeat. Students, there is a cup on the table. Teacher, spoon. Student, there is a spoon on the table. Teacher, book. Students, there is a book on the table. Teacher, on the chair. Students, there is a book on the chair, etc. Main features of audio-lingual method. Each skill like listening, speaking, reading, writing is treated and taught separately. The skills of writing and reading are not neglected, but the focus throughout remains on listening and speaking. Dialogue is the main features of the audio-lingual syllabus. Dialogues are the chief means of presenting language items. They provide learner an opportunity to practice, mimic and memorize bits of language. Pattern drills are used as an important technique and essential part of this method for language teaching and learning. The language laboratory was introduced as an important teaching aid. mother tongue was not given much importance, similar to the direct method, but it was not de-emphasized so rigidly. Techniques of this method. Skills are taught in the following order: listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Language is taught through dialogues with useful vocabulary and common structures of communication. Students are made to memorize the dialogue line by line. Learner mimic the teacher or a tab, listening carefully to all features of the spoken talked language. Pronunciation, like that of native speaker, is important in presenting the model. Through repetition of phrases and sentences, a dialogue is learned by the first whole class, then smaller group, and finally individual learners. Reading and writing are introduced in the next stage. The oral lesson learnt in previous class in the reading material to establish a relationship between speech and writing. All reading material is introduced as orally first. Writing in the early stages is confined to transcription of the structures and dialogues learnt earlier. Once learners mastered the basic structure, they were asked to write composition reports based on the oral lesson. Emphasizing the audio. The theory emphasizes the listening, speaking, reading, writing order. Listening is important in developing speaking proficiency and so receives particular emphasis. There are strong arguments, both physiological and psychological, for combining speaking practice with the training in listening comprehension. Speaking is effective through listening. By hearing the sounds, articulation is more accurate. With the differentiation of sounds, memorization and internalization of proper auditory sounds images, development of a feel for the new language gains interest for the language. There has been practically no much study or experiments to determine how much time should be taken between listening experience and speaking practice. Listening comprehension is the most neglected in language learning. It is generally treated as incidental to speaking rather than as a foundation for it. Texts, guides, and course of study contain tests for evaluating progress in listening comprehension, but they rarely contain specific learning materials designed for the systematic development of this skill. Here are some materials that can be adapted for improving listening comprehension. The dialogue should be presented as a story in the foreign language using simple language. The meaning of some of the new words and expressions that will appear in the dialogue should be explained through gestures, visual aids, synonyms, etc. The idea is to teach the content in the story. Different role plays can be used to present the dialogue. Without stopping, the dialogue can be gone through to hear how the entire conversation sounds at normal speed. True and false activity can improve comprehension. The entire dialogue can be repeated at normal rate speed. The student can close his eyes to eliminate distractions and increase his listening concentration. A listening comprehension test can be given. Listening comprehension practice can be given using dialogues from other courses of study or recorded materials that contain most of the language that has previously been learned by the students. The speaking practice would begin after listening comprehension. The students will be ready to speak at this time. Speaking practice can proceed according to sequence. Pattern practice can be based on material taken from the dialogue. Mimicking can practice the dialogue itself. Performance of the dialogue in front of class and at the seats with the students, changing roles and partners from time to time. Dialogue can be adapted. Memorization of techniques suggested represent an approach that will enable students to memorize larger segments at a time and perform dialogues as a whole with more confidence. In the meantime, if teachers are willing to use their imagination and experiment with new techniques, many ways can be found to emphasize the audio in the method. Advantages of audio-lingual method. Listening and speaking skills are emphasized, and especially the former, rigorously developed. The use of visual aids is effective in vocabulary teaching. The method is just as functional and easy to execute for larger groups. Correct pronunciation and structure are emphasized and acquired. It's a teacher-dominated method. It's a mechanical method since it demands pattern practice, drilling, and memorization. The learner is in a directed role. The learner has little control over the material studied or the method of study. It is grounded on a solid theory of language learning. Disadvantages. The behaviorist approach to learning is now discredited. Many scholars have proved its weakness. It doesn't pay sufficient attention to communicative competence. Only language form is considered while meaning is neglected. Equal importance is not given to all four skills. Conclusion. This essay clearly explains about audio-lingual method of language teachings, aims, techniques, features, oral drills, advantages and disadvantages step by step logically. Thank you.